We now have the GMA Morning Mix, the stories people are buzzing about. This morning, we're going to tackle everything from anger in the not-so-friendly skies to politics to Jay-Z's diss of the new We Are the World. Mm-hmm. Here with us to debate all that, our O Magazine editor-at-large, Gail King, also Republican strategist, Kevin Madden. Thanks for being here, guys.
Yeah. Let's mix it up.
Let's start an air raid.
Let's play.
Theme of the week. It started out Kevin Smith on Southwest Airlines, of course, the movie director, getting very angry when he's told to get off the plane because he's too fat. He fought back on Twitter and his podcast.
Look, I'm fat. I'll be the first to tell you I'm fat, but I ain't that fat yet. I haven't hit that bar yet.
Our dot-com board just lit up with all that. In the meantime, your former boss, Mitt Romney, coming back from the Olympics, he asked the person in front of him not to recline the seat, and the guy takes a slug at him, but he showed restraint.
Right.
Because he knows everybody's on as YouTube.
Exactly.
He doesn't want a YouTube moment.
And he knows that it would have been on Twitter within 2 seconds. That was one of the things that the governor knew right away. You know, he called my friends and colleagues up in Boston and said, you know, this may get out because, you know, he just knew.
I think so.
He just knew that this was going to be something that in a social media world that everybody was going to be talking about and everybody was going to get word of. Whereas, you know, if it were anybody else, it wouldn't be news.
We wouldn't hear about it. But people are cranky. People are cranky these days, George. When you get on airlines, people are just all pent up and all tense. Kevin Smith, as he said, it's no secret to him that he's overweight. What I think was wrong is once he's seated in the seat with his seatbelt fastened and the armrest down, to be publicly humiliated that way, there has got to be a better way and a better system. I think it's great that he's going on and saying, look, this is what happened to me. And he has a voice to let us know. It's not good.
But as George said, our message board lit up and a lot of people were supporting Southwest Airlines. A lot of people came out in defense and saying that, and I know in his case,
but
he was on standby.
His armrest was down.
And he was on standby.
And he normally buys two seats.
But he said he buys two seats because he doesn't want someone sitting next to him, not because of the.
This is not an arbitrary incident. This was something that is a longstanding 25-year policy. And I think, you know, if you look at Southwest Point, they don't sell tickets. What they sell are seats. Mm-hmm. And if you have to take up more than one seat, then you have to pay for it. So,
but Kevin,
I think the public shaming thing is very
difficult. But his armrest was down, and he had the seatbelt fastened.
I'm one of those guys that fights with the armrest guy all the time.
But I just think if you meet the criteria of that, your armrest is down and your seatbelt is fastened, how can they ask you to leave the plane?
Mm.
How can they do that?
There's just so much pent-up rage when you're traveling. You know, you're trying to get your bag down, and everyone's like pressuring you to get out the plane.
After all you've been through just to get on the plane.
Not only that, but with the weather nowadays, there's been more and more delays. People are sitting in these airports longer and longer, and that rage is starting to get pent up.
Well, something that we were talking about at my apartment building last night, I was about to go out to dinner, and you know, we were talking about things that we were going to talk about this morning, and we got on the subject of Jay-Z, who really came out, and it was like one of those things that everybody wanted someone else to say it. They didn't want to be the first one to say it. We Are the World, the remake of We Are the World.
And when Jay-Z speaks, people listen.
They do listen.
Sort of like,
yeah, in fact, he did. He gave an interview to MTV and gave his feelings about the remake here of We Are the World. Here's Jay-Z.
We Are the World. I love it, and I understand the point, and I think it's great, but I think We Are the World is like Thriller to me. I don't ever want to see it touched.
It's like a classic
that
you don't want to. And we should say Jay-Z and Beyonce have donated $1.5 million to Haitian relief. Yes. So that's not the issue here.
And Jay-Z and Bono and Rihanna had done a great song, Stranded, that they did for Haiti relief, that they did during the telethon, which was an amazing song.
But let me take the other side here, though. No, maybe that, you know, it is.
You're going to be the only one here.
I know I'm going to be the only one, but I just loved hearing it again. And I love the idea that across generations.
I'm going to move over to George.
I'm here with Kevin.
Because I really do think it's not like they brought it out for no reason. It's a classic. It's true. And I think that to put a new spin on it with new artists for the reason that they, well, we're in the 21st century, Robin. I mean, I'm not saying auto-tune was great.
The goal is to try to instill this whole ethic of giving back. And it did
that's wonderful. That's great, but you could find another way of doing it. It just, to a lot of people, took away from the original purpose of the song. And it's great that it brought attention.
I don't think anything can take it away. Yeah. It's taken away from the original
purpose. I would agree with that. I think that We Are the World, the original, was something that was crystallized in a lot of people's pop culture memory growing up. It became something that you could always look back at. There was a point, you know, a starting point in 25 years ago that kind of created a lot of people's love for music. And then to see it altered in a way and sort of kind of reintroduced. I think it's like Caddyshack 2. It's like Caddyshack 1.
Classic.
You can't, don't touch it.
Don't even touch it.
Why didn't anybody say anything about this?
But can you imagine
when they were doing it? When it was first reported that they're doing We Are the World, it was like, great, great. I wonder who's going to be in it. Who's going to get the solos? Quincy and Lionel back together.
Which
Michael and Janet singing together.
Back.
Nobody said at that time.
We hadn't heard it yet because we hadn't heard it.
The only thing that will justify it is a lot of money going to a good cause.
Yes. That's it.
That's it.
That we all agree on. We all agree on
that. We got a couple minutes left.
Okay, George, I'll move
back over there. Evan Bayh, big news this week.
Yes.
No one thought he was going to retire as senator from Indiana.
The way he did it, too, George. It just came out of the blue to me.
Mm-hmm. Surprised an awful lot of people.
I mean, and here's a guy, when you think, here's somebody who was considered one of the good guys, and I just think, if you feel that there's a problem, why not stay and try to fix a problem? And to me, it was just, you hear it and you think, no, not really. He's ahead in the polls. He has the money in his chest. So it's not like he was in danger of losing. It was just kind of a shock. And I was disappointed to see him go.
I'll tell you, if anything, the fact that it was such a surprise is just emblematic of how frustrated many of these centrists in Washington have become. Because right now they see the debate only taking place on the polar opposites of the political debate, and there's nothing really in the middle, and they feel lost, and they feel without sort of, you know, an infrastructure to help them get things done.
But do you agree with this charge he made that the system is broken? Rather, I know a lot of Republicans are saying, wait a second, no, Democrats are in charge right now. They're just not doing what they should be doing.
Well, there is a lot of dysfunction. I think the American public would agree with Evan Bayh that right now that there's this giant canyon between Congress and Washington's priorities and the American public's.
Mm-hmm. It is so snarky, and I'm curious for you, Kevin, is it wrong for a Republican to say a Democrat has a good idea and wrong for a Democrat to say a Republican has a good idea? It seems so seventh grade to me many times, and I'm just not going to take your side just because, George, you have on that tie. Because
just cause.
What's wrong with this tie?
My mom's a Democrat, so I have to agree with Democrats.
You know, we can keep going all morning,
but
it's all we have time for this morning. I hope you guys come back.
It's
terrific.
We need us to be invited. It's funny because Margo, the producer, said it's such an exciting day. We have Sadie, the winner of the Westminster. We have Leonardo DiCaprio, and we have you guys.